Actually, trick is Ilagovan.
Thank you, Honorable Vice Chairman. While thanking His Excellency for addressing the joint session of this House, this Parliament, on behalf of the DMK, I want to register certain points, sir. Sir, my first assessment of this address is that this address has made many mountains out of molehills. All small things were exaggerated to big things. As a first case, I can quote, financial inclusion is key to poverty alleviation. So, 26 crore plus Jandan accounts have been opened for the unbanked. Sir, opening bank accounts will only include the names in the bank ledgers. Now, it cannot be called as financial inclusion. Financial inclusion means they should have finance to operate the accounts. In most of these banks, savings banks account, at least 40% to 45% are either dormant or inoperative accounts. So merely opening accounts in a bank does not mean it is financial inclusiveness. It is only inclusion of names in the bank ledgers. Beyond that, there is nothing they can claim. Secondly, sir, I want to quote the recent report by Oxfam on the economic inequality in India. The report says 57 millionaires in India possess as much as the poorest 70% of the country. The wealth of the 70% of the poor is equivalent to just 57 men, 57 citizens in India. The report further says that governments lose tax and valuable income, with the super rich depositing their wealth in tax havens abroad and manipulating political systems to do so without repercussion. This was found in the Oxfam report. What I want to say is, the government was promised to bring back the black money invested in foreign countries. But since they could not do so, they want to show off, they want to present a picture that this government is against black money. They have taken up this demonetization excess. I can say, sir, out of the total population of this country, 69% are agriculturists. We know that agricultural income does not attract income tax. About 6 to 7% are fishermen. We know that fishing income does not attract income tax. Remaining at least 15 to 16% are monthly salaried classes. In that also, 7% have paid tax. The remaining income of the remaining people whose income will not fall under the threshold of taxation, that is, it will be less than 3 lakhs. That is why they are paying tax. Only 7 to 8% of the people of India, population of India, hold heavy money. See, we have a proverb in Tamil. Mootapoochiki bayandhu veetta koluthiradhu. It means burning the house to kill the bedbugs. That is what this government has done. They have burnt the house to kill the bedbugs. Beyond that, there is no fruitful less of this exercise. This is only to hide the government's failure in bringing the money from black money invested overseas to India. It was the promise made during the elections, and the Prime Minister had assured that that is his prime priority. Further, sir, there are many things which boasts of, I don't know, this Swachh Bharat. See, the local bodies are directly involved in the cleanliness of the cities. I don't know how much of this cess collected by the government of India on Swachh Bharat scheme is given to the local bodies. And the one more point, sir, that is about the simultaneous elections. This is a serious issue which has been going on, discussed in various fora. First thing, sir, the simultaneous elections is possible only in a two-party democracy. We are a multi-party democracy. Secondly, if we are following a first-past-the-post system in electing declaring a candidate and elected. If it is a proportional representation, then also simultaneous election is possible. One incident I want to quote. In 1996, we had parliamentary elections. In 1998, we once again had parliamentary elections. In 1999, we had parliamentary elections. If, when the parliament is dissolved, can we dissolve all the assemblies and conduct simultaneous elections? It is not possible. It has to be a, the system has to change. We must have at least proportional representation in elections so that simultaneous elections can be possible. Sir, I can appreciate certain things in this president's address because they have followed the steps of our party leader Dr. Kalaignar when he was chief minister in Tamil Nadu. In 1974 itself, Tamil Nadu had 100% village electrification, rural electrification. Women self-help groups formed in the year 1989 when our leader was the chief minister. Slum clearance boards and group housing schemes. Subsequently, the group housing scheme which was started in Tamil Nadu was followed up by the government of India and was called Indira Awas Yojana. It was appreciated by Jayaprakash Narayan himself. Then free gas connection to the rural poor, we did it in the year 1996 itself. So what we have done in Tamil Nadu long back when the DMK was in power, some of the features appear in the president's address, which is a welcome measure. Otherwise, as I said, this address can be termed as making mountains out of molehills. With these words, I thank you, sir.
Dhanyavad.